G'day, welcome to Evention. On today's episode, we're going to discuss how to get your horse more forward and why it's so important and can help you with some of your more common problems. Okay, so you might be saying, it's pretty obvious that we want our horses to go forward. And you'd be right. It's one of the fundamental understandings that the horse must have if he's going to be a riding horse, no matter what discipline that you do. But it's interesting, a lot of your common questions to me about certain issues actually all end up being related to going forward and the horse's misunderstanding of that at times. So if you're experiencing simple things like the horse being inconsistent in the transitions or in his frame, or that he's being really lazy and extra hard work to keep going, that the horse gets on the forehand and feels like a wheelbarrow full of bricks dragging you around, it can even escalate to things such as stopping at fences, crow hopping or kicking out at your leg when you ask him to canter, and even rearing. So it's really important that the horse has a great and very clear understanding that when we apply our aids, that he must move forward. Now there's a difference between moving forward and going fast. A horse can be going in a straight line at the trot or canter and not actually be forward. And by that I mean that he feels like he's in front of the leg. If you take a small analogy, it's kind of like when you're on a motorbike and you give it some throttle, it feels like the motorbike sinks down and goes under and goes and is wanting to jump forward. That's kind of the feeling we want to have with the horses all the time, that when we apply our leg, we get an instant reaction and can feel them moving forward into the bit. And this is the beginning of the horse's understanding going on the bit as well. So, now that we've understood that, let's go to our invention tip of the day.
Alright guys, since we're coming into the summer and spring season, we basically have our horses living in fly sheets, and half the time these buckles come undone or they become loose and you have to go out there and rebuckle them. So my invention tip is to get a braiding rubber band, and once you've buckled it, all you have to do is just put the rubber band around twice and it'll help keep it fastened for you. Alright, back to the action.
Welcome back guys. So let's talk about our aids. Our aids are the way we communicate to the horse and tell him to go forward. Our going forward aids are most importantly our lower leg, but we also can use our seat, our voice, and we have our artificial aids of our spur and stick. Now, a horse can feel a fly land on its ass and he'll swish his tail. So we can definitely feel our aids. But what's important here is what do those aids mean to him? So when we want, say, imagining we want our horse to go forward here into the walk and then into the trot, our first aid always has to be our most ideal amount of pressure first, so the lightest. So we will just squeeze him gently with our calves and hopefully he moves forward and understands that very clearly. Now, if he didn't, our next step, very quickly after that, would be to more pulse energy, give him more of a sharper burst of a squeeze to encourage him that, hey, let's get going. And if you fail to listen to that further still, then we would go to our spur or to our stick. Now, this needs to be a very fluid motion. You need to be able to move through these very quickly so that he understands that you're not just hitting him for the sake of hitting him. And then, more importantly still, is that we are super consistent with this. We want to always ask in that order or in that scale so that the horse always has the option to go with the lightest pressure first. It's a lot to get your head around, but being consistent is what's going to teach the horse to be more sensitive to the aids rather than by forcing him or trying to scare him forward. Yes, sometimes we need to be firmer to reinforce our initial point, but always allowing that option first to go from an easier pressure is going to mean we're going to have to hit him less or spur him less later in his training. All right? let's head to a Schrammo shout out. Today's Schrammo shout out's a little bit different. What I want you to do is go out and volunteer at a local horse event. Our sport relies on volunteers, and it's a great way to get outside and maybe learn something watching good riders go around. All you need to do is find a local event, contact the event organizer, ask them if they need a hand, and Bob's your uncle. So get out there and help out. Back to the action. Okay, so my first exercise is just simply riding forward and back transitions at all three gates. Jimmy's going around here at the trot right now. She's gonna practice going slow, and then when she applies her leg, she wants to feel that surge forward that the horse wants to go somewhere and do it willingly. We do this at all three gates until it feels very fluid, very smooth, and that the horse is very happy. Okay, so my second exercise is using trot poles and slightly lengthening them over a short amount of time to help extract and get the horse's stride out a little bit longer. For a stiff horse, this may make him a little bit more forward thinking. So start with trot poles that are very comfortable for your horse. And once you've successfully gone through those, we're going to just make them a little bit wider, and then the next time, try and get that horse's step out a little bit. So let me adjust these now. So roll the poles out by no more than 6 inches at a time. And now you've got to come in with a little bit more trot. Okay, Jimmy, let's give this a try. The idea of this is that if the stretch of the horse's stride makes him feel a bit more comfortable, then maybe he's a little bit more willing to go forward. Good. You can see Bellamy was stretching a little bit more, and hopefully he feels a little bit looser. Now on to exercise three. Okay, my last exercise is a little bit different and may be good for a horse that really doesn't respond to your leg well. What I'm going to do is train a voice aid starting from the ground. So this could be useful for you if he's more responsive to your voice. It may help you out in reinforcing your leg aid when you're on the horse. So let's test him out here. I want him to go into the trot. Whatever noise you want to make, he doesn't respond. So now I'm going to click him and follow with the lunge whip and teach him that my voice means go forward. Good boy. Now, I'll let him walk again. Let's see if our voice works any better now. Ah, great. So you could see there that if I continue to train this, when he was behind my leg when I'm riding him, maybe I can make him go from my leg by reinforcing with my voice. This is a useful tool for a young horse or one that really doesn't want to go forward and pins his ears back and gets cranky. All right, guys, that wraps up another episode. Hope you got a few ideas to get your horse thinking more forward. Remember, repetition and consistency is key. See you next week. Now we use these to tell him what we want, and it's up to, dang it.
All right, and action.
You are so annoying.
Yeah.